Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Today we were supposed to do the Vishnu Sahasranam playlist, but today is a very special video for a very special day, because on 2nd June, which is tomorrow, by the time you see this video, it is a very, 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 very special day. It is Pandav Nirjal Ekadashi Day. This is a very important day. These days are very crucial, like Akshaya Tritiya, Diwali, Ram Navami, Janmashtami, Shivratri. These days are very auspicious, and therefore I made this video today so that you can fast tomorrow and you can do so many things tomorrow. All right, so if you are watching this, then make sure you spare aside some time for tomorrow, right? Because these days don't come every day. All right, so what is tomorrow? It is known as Nirjal Ekadashi, or it is also known as Pandav Nirjal Ekadashi. Why do they say it as Nirjal Ekadashi? So what is Ekadashi basically? Ekadashi is one of the tithis. So tithi is, in astrology, it's the distance between sun and moon. We'll make videos on tithis later. But the tithi, actually, the different tithis are ruled by different planets. So, for example, Ekadashi is ruled by Mars, Mangal. And therefore, these tithis can be very beneficial to us if we use them in the right context. So, for example, tomorrow is Pandav Nirjal Ekadashi. So, tomorrow is just like another Ekadashi, which means the event is the same astrologically. There's nothing special. There's no special planetary combination for this. It is just a normal Ekadashi as per astrology, tithi wise. But it is very special. And Ekadashis are generally considered very auspicious, because on those days, it is said that we should do more spiritual practices, because we can get much, much, much more benefits, hundreds and thousands of times more than general days. Okay, Ekadashis are very potent. Ekadashis are specially blessed by Lord Vishnu, Lord Hari, Lord Narayan, so that we can use these days for our benefit. So therefore, if you are not following Ekadashis, then it's very crucial and that you start following. So what is the most important thing to do in Ekadashi? There are certain primary things and there are secondary things. Okay, most of the people know about the secondary things. That's what is the problem in India, especially these days. People know all the the rules, regulations, do's and don'ts, but they don't know, they forget the main purpose. Okay, so secondary thing is, which is not very important, which is also very important, of course. It's not that it is not, but it is secondary. So the secondary thing is, we should not eat grains on that day. Okay, so on 2nd, it is best if you only eat fruits, or you can eat sabudana or varai or milk or all these things you can eat, but please avoid grains. Okay, and it's also good to avoid sugar and salt. But Ekadashi sugar, Ekadashi salt is available. I don't know if it is available in the West, but in India it's available. So if you cannot resist, then you can take Ekadashi salt, Ekadashi sugar and all this. Okay, so you can Google what are the things which are allowed in Ekadashi. Okay, so I will not speak much about it here, because it's already there in Google. So Lord Vishnu had blessed Kaliraj that even if somebody offers this food to me on Ekadashis, which means if you make grains and you offer to Lord Vishnu, then he he will of course accept it, but the sin is always there. Okay, so it's like saying he doesn't accept it. Okay, so we should not offer grains to Lord Vishnu on Ekadashis. That's not recommended. And we also should not eat grains during Ekadashis. Okay, it's considered very sinful. Now, if you are on a different level, if you are eating meat and if you are taking wine and, you know, onion and garlic, then though it's like royal crap, you should never take them in Ekadashis. So if you are eating meat and all this, then Then on Ekadashis, you should try to be a vegetarian at least for one day. And apart from that, if you can, then try to avoid grains, okay? Warai is one thing and Sabudana is one thing which people take. So these are secondary things, but these are not very important. The most important thing is in an Ekadashi, you should do more spiritual practices, okay? So therefore, Ekadashis are very powerful, and the great acharyas from different sampradayas, which we know, they have always been focusing on Ekadashi. So please get up early on second and do your mantras. Do double the number of rounds. If you are doing 4 rounds, do 8 rounds. If you are doing eight, then do 16. If you are doing 16, do 32. Okay. So these days are very potent actually. And the thing is, why this special Ekadashi is known as Nirjal Ekadashi, and this is known as Pandav Nirjal Ekadashi. Why? Because we know from the Mahabharata, the five Pandavas headed by Yudhishthir, Bhim, Arjun, Nakul, Sahadev, the five Panch Pandav, as they say, these personalities, they were like pinnacle of Dharma, okay, headed by Dharmaraj Yudhishthir, of course. That is why he's known as Dharmaraj. But there were still some problems. So the Pandavas would very obediently do Ekadashis. Every Ekadashi they would do. And they would do Nirjal. Nirjal means no food, no water, nothing. Okay. So sometimes you can also do Sajal Ekadashi. Sajal means with water. Okay. Best is if you do Nirjal every Ekadashi. And then if you cannot do, then you should do Sajal, okay, with water. That's a bit lower, second class. Then third class is you take fruits, okay. Then there is fourth class Ekadashi. Fourth class Ekadashi means you take Varai, Sabudana, and milk and all this, okay. Then there is fifth class. I don't know what's fifth class. Fifth class is like no Ekadashi. You are eating grains, okay. So that's not recommended. So at least general Ekadashis, you should not take grains, okay. Now the thing is, Bhim, who is the next after Yudhishthira Maharaj, after him this Ekadashi is named. Okay, so that is, this Ekadashi is also sometimes known as Bhima Ekadashi. And what happened? Because Bhima is a very Herculean warrior and he's a great personality, so now he's somehow the son of Vayu, Pavandev. He was born from the niyog of Pavandev and Kunti Devi. Therefore, it is next to impossible for him. It is said in the Mahabharata that in Bhima's stomach, there is a constant fire which is going on. It's like a Vayu which is going on, which extinguishes anything that comes inside. Okay. So therefore, it was very, very, very difficult for him to follow Ekadashis. He literally would feel as if he will die. He cannot fast. He's like, you tell me to go and break mountains, I will break. You tell me to punish somebody, I will do. You tell me to do anything, I will do. But don't tell me to fast. I cannot fast. It's very difficult for me. And Yudhishthir and Kunti and Draupadi and Arjun and Nakul, Sahadev, they always used to be very concerned because Bhima's situation would not be very good during Ekadashi. So and then he would go to, one day he thought, this is it, enough of it, I cannot follow Ekadashi. And then he went to Yudhishthir Maharaj and said, my dear brother, I am very sorry, I cannot fast on Ekadashi, it's not possible, I have to eat from tomorrow. And Yudhishthir said, no, you cannot do that, you cannot break the scriptural injunctions, that will not give you happiness in the long run. As Krishna also says, you know, nasa siddhim avapnoti na sukham na param gatim. One who disregards the injunctions of the scriptures does not attain peace either in this life or next, or does not, or nor does he attain ultimate goal or destination of life. So Yudhishthir Maharaj told him that you should go and check with Maharishi Vyas. He is the only one who can suggest what you should do. Okay. Then he went to Vyasdev and he fell at his feet. He said, oh, great sage Vyasdev, please, please, please give me some way. Give me some allowance because I am not able to fast and I feel like dying on Ekadashis. It's like I'm on the verge of death. Then Vyasdev, seeing Bhima's plight and understanding his precarious situation. In fact, it is said, when Kunti Devi used to cook for the Pandavas, then what she used to do is, she would distribute the food, the total amount, into two parts. So one part was exclusively for Bhima. And then she would divide the rest into five parts. So five for four Pandavas and one for herself. Okay. And when Draupadi came as the wife of the five Pandavas, then Kunti told her the same thing. That she told to Draupadi that, my dear Draupadi, when next time you are cooking, please make sure you cook it and then half you give to Bhima. Okay. And then the remaining half, you divide it into six parts. The four Pandavas, you and me. Okay, so that is how much Bhima used to eat. And yes, he used to eat and he used to do a lot of activities also. You know, like if you've seen the Mahabharata, Kurukshetra war, he was the one who wiped out all the 100 Kauravas. Okay, so many times some idiots, thugs and jokers and rascals these days in social media, I see they make fun of Bhima. They say, oh, he was, you know, he used to eat too much and all this nonsense. These people will, they will see what karma is, okay, if you insult this great personality. So you are allowed to eat more. You are allowed to eat 10 times, 1,000 times more if you are taking load also accordingly, okay. So Bhima was not overweight. He was not a victim of, he was not a patient of obesity or high blood pressure or diabetes and all this, okay. So many times people, they make fun of Bhima. They say, oh, this person was, you know, just eating like this. No, not like that. For him, he needed, that is why he used to eat, okay. So nobody should make fun of Bhima like this. If you do, then you will suffer terribly and you will have major consequences in life, okay. Which you may not feel that, oh, how it will happen. But it will happen. Don't worry. It will happen. Okay. So don't create trouble for yourself by insulting these great personalities, whoever they are. So therefore, Vyasdev told him, all right, I understand that it is very difficult for you to fast. Therefore, among all the Ekadashis, there is one special Ekadashi, which is this Ekadashi, which is coming for us this year, June 2nd. You fast, and if you fast on this day, this Ekadashi alone, no water, no food, no grains, no sabudana, no milk, nothing, then you will get the result of fasting on all the Ekadashis. Okay, so then when Bhima heard, he was happy and sad. He was jubilant because he understood that now he does not have to fast on Ekadashis. He can take fruits at least. But he was still unhappy that there's one day which he has to fast in that year, all right? But then he was still jubilant that, okay, we will somehow, somehow I will do that for one day, okay? And then Bhima took a resolution that every Nirjal Ekadashi, every specific Ekadashi, he will always fast, okay? And therefore, even if you cannot do any Ekadashi, if you are not up to that level, then this day, second, try to do Ekadashi. Even if you cannot do Nirjal Ekadashi, first level, then you try to do Sajal, okay? Then, even then, you can, if you can't do, then level three, you take milk, then, or, you know, take fruits, or worst case, you take Sambudana and Varai, okay? So, in my case, I will be fasting totally. So, after dinner of 1st June, I will be directly taking breakfast on 3rd. Okay, so no food, no water, nothing. I'll be fasting totally. Hopefully, I will be able to, unless I faint. Okay, so now, if sometimes if you are, your body is not having proper composition to burn fat, then it might be difficult. But try your best. Even if you can fast till 12 or till 4 or till sunset, it is worth it. Okay. Ideal is highest standard, you know, Nirjal, no water, whole day, nothing. And I will give the link for this and you can enter your location in drikpanchang.com. and it will tell you on third what time you have to break the fast. Okay, so it is different for different places, remember. So you will find it in dritpanchang.com. So go to the link and check when you have to break the fast on third. Okay, and the tithi is starting on first itself, but because it is after sunrise, so we take the second June tithi. Okay, I mean we take the date as second June, so the tithi already starts on first, but we will do the fasting on second. Okay, so therefore no doubts, no compromise with that. At least that is how it is for Germany. Okay, and you can check how is it for India, in which place you stay. The sunrise is earlier, it may go to first also, so check it accordingly and benefit yourself. Okay, thank you very much. If you're new, then please subscribe to the channel, and if you want a consultation from me, then please go down to the description section of my videos where you'll find the link to my website. All right, God is there with you all the time, just look to him and you will find him.